Hello friends, welcome to the NTB Dialogues. We will be talking about tuberculosis but also related lung health issues, which are also very important. We are here at the 50th Union World Conference on Lung Health, which is taking place in Hyderabad in India. After 50 years, this conference has come back to India. India is has highest burden of tuberculosis in the world, and a very significant big chunk of tobacco use is here, and other lung health ailments including asthma, air pollution, for example. We have amongst us a very distinguished person, A. Sankar from Empower Foundation, and he has been a very credible voice in several HIV, health, justice, human rights movement, and he hails from south of India, but he has a huge influence in India and abroad. Welcome, Sankar. Welcome so much, and thanks a lot for your support to public health. So I know something happened today at the conference in the session in which you were around asthma. Can you please share more of the progress which has been made?
Thank you, Bobby. Today the World Health Conference is in Hyderabad. Today morning we had a plenary session on deadly air. I spoke about the impact of air pollution on individual related to asthma. See, I am representing a civil society organization, Empower India. We are working with grassroots communities for the past 28 years. We are affiliated with UNCCD, UNEP, and we have UN ECOSOC status also. We have been working in our health and rights issue. Today I spoke about asthma and air pollution, because myself is suffering from asthma due to air pollution since 2000, and this is one of the major issues as far as India is concerned, because the global also, the poor air quality leads to depression and bipolar disorder. The studies shows that once in every 10 asthma patients in the world is in India. 90% of childhood asthma and 50% of adult asthma is caused due to environmental allergies. Outdoor air pollution is another important trigger. For the first time, the researchers found associations between long-term exposure to outdoor air pollution and current asthma in adults. See, in Delhi, one 28-year-old woman who is a non-smoker diagnosed with stage 4 lung cancer due to air pollution. This is the worst part, is the woman is a non-smoker.
But tobacco is known for lung cancer.
Yes, it's that too in stage 4.
So tobacco is not the only cause of lung cancer.
Yes, the air pollution. So we should be very cautious, and Delhi is very much polluted, and the most of the cities in India are polluted. So we have to be careful, and we have to do something more on this issue, because everybody is talking about HIV/AIDS, everybody is talking about TB, but there is no voice for asthma. So my humble submission is that this is the time to voice for asthma too. So what we have to do is,
this was the presentation today.
So my humble submission is that how can you safeguard yourself from city's toxic air? Whenever you go out, check the air pollution levels before heading out. Number two, avoid going to the areas with high traffic levels. Avoid working outdoors during high air pollution levels. Don't burn wood or trash. And in general, the consumers, I have 7 R's that is applicable to all consumers. They have to apply in their routine, in the day-to-day affairs. Rethink your choices. Always you rethink your choices and refuse single use and reduce consumption. Reuse everything. Whatever possible, you please reuse everything. Refurbish old stuff. Repair before you replace. Everything, if possible, we should repair. And repurpose. We should be creative and reinvent whatever may be repurpose. And last but least, the last option is recycle. So this has to be adopted in everyday life. The consumer should not consume for others. They should consume for themselves, and they should, as far as possible, they should reduce the consumption. And for to voice for the asthma community, today at 50th Wellang Conference at Hyderabad, we decided to launch a forum, that is Global Asthma Community Forum, for effective lobbying and advocacy with various stakeholders. Because the forum is for AIDS is there, the forum is for TB is there, but this is also a very important issue to be taken up. So my humble submission to all stakeholders to take up this. Asthma is also one of the big burden for all our fellow citizens. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sankar, and I really wish the best for this forum. It is asthma is such an acute issue, not only in terms of the burden, but also in the terms of preparedness of health system. And as Sankar rightly pointed out, air pollution and it can also trigger this. And that is why when there are changes in the air, people with asthma or people who are more susceptible to asthma, they really need to take care. But Sankar, I've heard that if we people with asthma can live normal lives, if asthma is managed well, there is no need for critical hospitalization, ICU visits, if the person is able to manage asthma well. Is it true? And how can a person with asthma manage asthma well and lead normal lives, as probably there is no cure, if I have heard right? We have to manage it and live fully. Can you please shed some light, as you are yourself have experiential knowledge of asthma?
Yes, I am asthmatic patient. You have to be very careful, because you should carry always inhaler with you. Always I carry inhaler with me, because at any moment of time, due to any reason, it may be dust pollution or air pollution or street dust or in traffic, for any reasons you will get wheezing. All of a sudden you will get wheezing. At that time you should apply inhaler. Otherwise, you will suffocate, and that will lead to serious problems, and that leads to hospitalization also. So, if you are an asthmatic patient, always you should carry the prescribed inhaler with you, and don't go out in any chill area. That is very important. But this is also a serious problem as far as asthma itself, because there is no cure for it. So you have to survive with it. So you have to be very careful in your personal life.
Thank you so much, Sankar. Especially because probably this is a question for the research community, that why is there no cure for asthma? People, we are fighting for better diagnosis, better treatment for tuberculosis. We are struggling and fighting and calling for better drugs, better medicines, better vaccines in for TB, for HIV, for other health issues. Why not asthma? People of asthma also matter, and sustainable development goals clearly say where we need sustainable development where no one is left behind. Sankar, before we end, we would like to have your message as you are here at the 50th Union World Conference on Lung Health. You just came out from a session, you made a strong point on asthma and air pollution, and all the best for the global coalition on asthma. Please, your message from this conference for the way ahead, so that we not only address air pollution but also people with asthma can have better lives, and no one needs to fall, nothing should happen to trigger asthma in the first place.
Yes, you are correct. Asthma, there should be the inventions are going on. I hope in future we will get some kind of solution for this. But as far as this conference is concerned, as a civil society representative and an asthmatic person itself, I submit my request to all stakeholders, especially the union, the media persons, to take this asthma is also an important burden for life and country, for community. So we have to take more concentration on asthma disease also. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sankar. So friends, we were listening to A. Sankar from Empower in India. And this is part of the NTB Dialogues CNS series, which features insightful and thought-provoking interviews on a range of issues around TB, but also other lung health issues. So thank you. And for more information, be welcome to visit our website, www.citizen-news.org. Videos, podcasts, articles, and other online and other tools are up there. Thank you so much, and please do wait for the next episode of NTB Dialogues, which is going to feature a very special guest again, probably in next few hours. Thank you. Bye-bye.